essentially are trying to provide a functional cure for type 1 diabetes, which means replace the function of a whole pancreas, and we are replacing that by implanting cells into the body while protecting them using a plastic pouch. People who have type 1 diabetes wake up one day and they have lost the insulin producing cells within their pancreas, and that causes very high blood sugars, which can be deadly if not treated with insulin. They then learn that they have to use insulin for a lifetime in order to control their blood sugars. And unfortunately, these insulin injections that are currently available are not minute-to-minute regulating. And that is very problematic. It leads to long-term complications. What you're trying to do is essentially solve that problem, provide a functional cure by replacing the function of a pancreas with a subset of cells that actually produce and release insulin in response to the rise in blood sugar. So they provide minute-to-minute regulation. One of the most impactful innovations behind this cell therapy is the delivery method of oxygen into the implantable device. Without oxygen, the device would need to be as big as a person's torso. But by providing oxygen, the footprint of the device can be made very small and about as thick as a quarter. A small incision is made in the abdomen and the pouch is inserted under the skin so that it's fully hidden. Currently, we are using a wearable oxygen generator, but with the next iteration, the oxygen generator will be miniaturized and implanted under the skin. The device is made of three layers and is covered with special membranes that encourage blood vessels to form around it while keeping the immune system from attacking it like a foreign invader. The two outermost layers are filled with insulin-producing cells, and the middle layer is where oxygen is delivered. With sufficient oxygen, the insulin-producing cells have enough energy to function. Without oxygen, the cells will be ineffective. Glucose from the surrounding blood vessels passes through the membranes and enters into the insulin-producing cells, signaling them to release the appropriate amount of insulin into the blood vessels. So that is the vision, that you will have an implant, a small size implant, reasonable size implant, that would control your blood sugar and that you can forget about it. You don't have to think about it after it's implanted. As we plan on going to patients, you know, cell manufacturing, cell loading of the devices and everything we do needs to be under controlled environment and controlled conditions. So you want to make sure that everything is sterile, so people are properly trained, gowned, and you have the certifications you need. And it's something that we're very proud of. There are other clean rooms around the country, but having one here enables us to actually translate this and take it to patients when we are ready. It's really exciting to be part of a team that can go from A to Z, meaning from the bench to the patient.